At first glance, alcohol ink and foiling don't appear to be a sensible combination, but not only are they're just incredible when used together. The shiny metallic foils are a perfect companion to the rich, brilliant colors of the inks. In today's video, I'm working on Yupo and will show you how to find that in-between place where the alcohol ink reaches a tacky stage, allowing it to act like an adhesive for the foils. This technique of using the alcohol ink as it gets sticky before it's entirely dry to foil with is not mine. When I was at my friend Natalie's store in Montreal a little earlier this year, demoing at her event, one of the women who was attending stopped by and told me about it. We were playing with alcohol inks anyway, so we broke out the foil, and it's such an amazing thing and provides such awesome results that I knew I wanted to share it with you eventually. So not mine, this is just my interpretation of it. Alcohol inks are solvent-based, which means they don't dry so much as the solvent base evaporates off. And when you start to layer alcohol inks and when things start to move and you get these areas that push out, you get these darker ridges, alcohol ink, when it's dry, gets very matte looking. When it's wet, it's shiny, and you'll be able to sort of see that in-between state where it gets sticky enough to foil on, and that's perhaps the most amazing thing of all. So things will start to push around, and you'll see that I'm going to show you in 1 second, and the biggest thing for me is being patient. You have to find that in-between state, and there'll be some touching and messy fingers and all of those things going on as we try, or as I try to show you, how you experiment a little bit until you find that sticky state. So this piece right here has been foiled, and you can, let me turn it this way, you can actually see that it looks like there's sequins in that foil. This is a Gina K foil. This is one I actually did with two colors, and it's really hard to show you the foil without killing you with the glare, but you can see that I've got turquoise here. Let's see if I can hold that. There's turquoise there, and then there's pink, and I'm going to show you an alternate. There is a point where the solvent base will evaporate it enough that you're not sticky anymore. You're just dry and you can't go ahead and foil it. But I'm going to show you a workaround for that. We'll get there. And that's going to actually allow you to use a couple of different colors. So, nonstick craft sheet. This is all beat up from me working on it so much. Doesn't mean it doesn't work as a nonstick surface anymore, but it does mean if I get alcohol ink on here, it's going to get in these marks and it makes it very distracting to look at. So I'm just going to work. This is a sheet from a palette pad. I'm just going to work on there. I have 4 colors of alcohol ink. I have lemon, aquamarine, aqua, and citrus, and I don't know how much of any of them I'm going to use. We'll just play and see what happens. I have a coffee stirrer that has a bunch of different colors on it. You can clean it with 92% alcohol if you want. I don't, because sometimes you get interesting things that happen. So I'm just going to start by putting some of the colors out. Now what I'm working with here is not anything that would necessarily make a muddy mess anyway, but if I wanted to add some purple in here, it wouldn't. I mean, you'd have to work really hard to make a mess of this. And that's see what happens? There's pink on here. That's one of the beauteous things about alcohol inks, is how forgiving they are. So now that there's some pink in there, that makes me think I need to drop a little bit of pink in here. So let's grab a little bit of shell pink. And you see what happens, how those marks start to move around and they sort of soften. I call that blooming. The colors will continue to bloom until all the solvent base is gone. So I'm going to start by pushing some of this off as I make the marks in here. Now the marks will start to stay. You'll start to see them bloom less as I go along here. All I want to do is create kind of an interesting background. I'm not going to work real hard. I'm not going to try to foil anything on the background. I just want to get some color on here. And I can blow on this, and that'll kind of hasten the evaporative process. And I don't have to completely wait for this to dry anyway, but I'm just going to give it one more pass through here. And then I'm going to start bringing in, and I'm going to put drops on. Now, this area right here is liable. These areas are liable to be sticky as I go along. We'll just have to wait and see. So let's grab, this is shell pink. So let's grab some of the pink, and you'll see the pink is going to push the green out of the way, which means I get a pink circle with a green ring around it, and that's one of the more remarkable things that alcohol inks do. They are effortless for the most part. Once you learn to give over to the fact that they're pretty much going to do what they're going to do and you don't have a lot of control, you can kind of predict, but there's not a lot of control. Once you kind of give that up, not easy to do sometimes, but once you do, then you realize how much fun they are and how incredibly creative you can be with them. So all I'm doing is putting some drops on here. If I want to come back with a little bit of yellow, I can certainly do that, and that'll spice things up a little bit. And each time I add more liquid, it means I'm going to have to wait a little bit more for it to evaporate to that point where I can start to get sticky enough to foil. Now, nothing says that I can't come back and manipulate these colors if I want. There's no reason whatsoever not to do that. If I want to then just kind of wave at this and get it going here and then put some more drops in, I can do that too. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is actually let this bloom and then let this process happen. So foil, while this is drying, because if I hold this up, see how wet and shiny that is? This is not ready by any stretch of the imagination. But what I am gonna do, let's grab another piece of palette paper because it does get very distracting. All right, so let's quickly talk about foil. These are some Gina K foils. And again, it's really hard to show this to you. Ooh, there's a good shot. Without the light reflecting in such a way that all you see is glare. So I'm just gonna quickly move through these. And someplace here is the, here's the gold one. There is actually a silver sequin too. I don't seem to have it here. But there's, besides the solid colors, there are all these wonderful effects. So when we talk about those, you have lots of different options. All right, so I can see that I'm starting to get drier in the center, but I'm still wet around here, which means I'm still not quite ready. So if I start to touch, you can see that that's way too wet to do anything with. So it's just, it's a matter of waving your hand over it and waiting for it to get to that point. So something that's interesting, I'm gonna foil with this color because there's enough contrast so that you'll really be able to see it. But one of the things that you'll notice as you go along, and this is a piece I was working with earlier, that's alcohol ink on the back. It's because I put it down in a section that wasn't sticky, it was still pretty wet. So the good news is that this doesn't affect what you see. When you foil, the silver side is what goes to your surface. All right, so let's just, ooh, we're almost there. All right, so let's try this right here. I'm gonna burnish with either my finger or my thumb, and then go ahead and pull that off. Okay, so you can see it right here. There it is. See that? Awesome. That is, it just amazes me. I got goosebumps the first time she showed this to me because I thought the effect was so remarkable. All right, so let's come in and try to do a bigger area here. Not entirely certain where we are in our sticky state, but we'll find out in just a second when I go to take this off. All right, so here is some, you can see some foiling going on here. We have reached the point, whoops, let's get rid of that. We've reached the point now where we've hit enough sticky that we're going to see some results. Oh, see, how awesome is that? Look at how marvelous that is. And you know, you don't have to necessarily color coordinate. Sometimes there can be a real advantage to choosing a very contrasting color like this because you really see the effects of the foil. All right, so this is looking pretty good. Let's just see if there's any more results to be had here. All right, so I think that I can maybe do right along here. I think that this is amazing. It just is so pretty. You get this awesome glimmer from the foil. You get the contrasting color in this case. And when you use one of these fancy schmancy ones, you also get these really cool effects. So what happens here eventually is that this is so dry that there's no more sticky and I'm not going to get any foiling. Now this is larger areas here sometimes you get when you have a little bit of accumulation or I've pressed really, really hard. But once you hit that point where you can't foil anymore, the alternate to that is to come in and to use something like this Deco Foil glue. This is a foiling glue, which means that when it dries tacky feeling, sticky, which is what attracts the foil. So I'm going to show you how to use some of this glue. It goes on white and dries clear, so that you can come in and if you want to add to what you've got there, you can. But interestingly enough, if I want to come back now and foil with an entirely different color, I can do that too. If you're working along and you miss the sticky stage, all isn't lost. There are certainly ways that you can come back and work around that. The first one is to go and put more alcohol ink on the piece you were working on and recreate some areas that will dry to sticky. Or the other one is to use the Deco Foil glue, which is meant to dry sticky so that the foil will adhere to it. Now, the interesting thing about this is that it is dimensional. If I hold this up, see how you can see dots on there, raised dots on there? That's the Deco Foil glue, and they actually would have been taller if I had waited long enough before I foiled this, and what I did was I ended up kind of smushing them flat. But you can see the foil marks on there. You can see the copper color reflecting off there. It really is difficult to show you the foiling without showing you the glare. That's not a bad view of it. Now this one, I came back and I wanted to add a second color foil, and the way to do that is, well, you could rush around and use two pieces of foil in the beginning, but the easy way to do that is to foil it first when the alcohol ink is at the sticky stage, and then come back with the glue and add it so that you can put your second color on. So where you see the turquoise, that was my initial, well, glare is brutal. That was my initial color of foil, and then I came back with this kind of purpley color and added a second layer. So when you do this, it's pretty straightforward. The glue comes in this container. It actually has a reasonably fine tip on it, so I'm just going to shake the glue down. Now the thing with the glue is it goes on white, and when it's clear, it's dry, and it's at that sticky state where you can actually get the foil to adhere. So I'm not going to talk here for a second. You can draw like that. You can make dots if you want. You can fill areas in. Obviously, the thicker the area, the longer it will take before it's dry enough to come back and foil. But you have the option to do lots of different things here. And this isn't anything I'm going to come back and worry about. It's just an opportunity for me to show you how to apply the glue. So it's white, which means it is not ready to go. But fortunately, I have a piece already prepared that if I hold this up into the light, well, you really can't see it. You can a little bit, but you'll see it when I start to foil it. So I'm going to use this really cool gold sequin, and I'm just going to come in and lay it down here and start pressing. Now, some of the foil has been used, so obviously I might have to come back and fill in, but I can feel the lines, so I'm just going to rub. Now, when you do this with the foil glue, because it's meant to actually foil, you don't have to press nearly as hard as you do when you're trying to, oh, how awesome is that, when you're trying to foil that in-between state when the alcohol ink is sticky. So let's just make certain I didn't miss anything. See, I knew there was a fairly good size area because I wanted you to see the sequins on there if possible. I think that's about everything at this point. But here's your opportunity to, again, if you miss your window and everything has gone too dry, then all you do is come back with the glue. So foiling an alcohol ink, not anything that would have ever occurred to me, but I am very glad that that wonderful person showed me when I was demoing, because I think that this is just a fabulous technique. Whether you're going to stick this on a journal page, or if you love it enough to stick it in a frame, or even for a card base, they make really wonderful pieces.